गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अ वीडियो फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8 सब्जेक्ट साइंस. वी वर स्टडिंग चैप्टर 10, दैट इज रीचिंग द एज ऑफ एडोलेसेंस. इट्स योर लेक्चर नंबर 3. इन द प्रोमोस नाउ वी विल डिस्कस सम मोर टॉपिक्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर्स. द टॉपिक्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड आर role of hormones in completing the life, and next is reproductive health. Let's start our first topic, that is role of hormones in completing the life, history of insects and frogs. Picture shows the life cycle of silk moth. We have already learned about the life history of silk moth and the frog. And we know that the caterpillar has to pass through various stages to become an adult moth. So, how an adult moth is developed? In this, the first stage of the life cycle of silkworm is an egg. Okay, the first stage is an egg. And the egg is laid by a female moth and it lays more than 350 eggs at a time. And after that, the growth of silkworm starts. Means larva is formed. And in this stage, the silkworm spin a protective cocoon around itself. And then pupa stage is formed. And after that, this pupa changes into an adult moth. Means a adult moth is developed, and in this way this female moth lays egg, means the female moth again lays egg, and this cycle continues. So here we can see that the caterpillar has to pass through various stages to become an adult moth. Similarly, the tadpole passes through certain stages to become a frog. Like in first stage, the tiny frog's eggs are laid in masses in the water by a female frog. And then the eggs hatches into tadpoles. And then tadpoles have a longer body. And then a young frog is developed. And in this stage, the almost mature frog breathes with lungs and still has some of its tail. And after that, an adult frog is developed. The adult frog breathes with lungs and has no tails. Means the tadpole passes through certain stages to become a frog. And this change from larva to adult is called metamorphosis. Okay, this change is called metamorphosis. And metamorphosis in insects is controlled by a hormone which is called insect hormone. So I repeat, the change from larva to adult is called metamorphosis. It is a very important term. Okay, so what is metamorphosis? The change from larva to adult is called metamorphosis, and metamorphosis in insects is controlled by insect hormone. In a frog, metamorphosis is controlled by thyroxine hormone, means a hormone which is produced by thyroid. In the previous lecture, we have learned that the thyroxine hormone is secreted by a thyroid gland. Remember? So, in a frog, the metamorphosis is controlled by thyroxine hormone. Thyroxine production requires the presence of iodine water. Means the thyroxine hormones is produced only when there is a presence of iodine water. If there is no iodine water, then the thyroxine hormone cannot produce. So if the water in which the tadpoles are growing does not contain sufficient iodine, then the tadpoles cannot become adults. Okay, this is the reason that water contains sufficient iodine. because if there is no presence of iodine, then the tadpoles cannot become adults. So, I repeat, thyroxin production requires the presence of iodine water. And if the water in which the tadpoles are growing does not contain sufficient iodine, the tadpoles cannot become adults. In this topic, we have learned that what are the role of hormones in completing the life of insects and frogs. Now, our next topic is reproductive health. A person is said to be healthy if he or she is physically and mentally fit. And as the body grows during adolescence, it is very important to be healthy. To keep the body healthy, every human being at any stage needs to have a balanced diet. Okay? Every human being needs a balanced diet. A person must also observe personal hygiene and undertake proper physical exercise. During adolescence, these become even more essential as the body is growing. So now we discuss that how can we keep our body healthy. So first is nutritional needs of adolescents. Adolescence is a stage of rapid growth and development. And an adolescent needs to eat a healthy and balanced diet. The diet should include protein, carbohydrate, fats, minerals, and vitamins in correct proportions. It is essential to eat rice, pulses, vegetables. Milk should also be included in the daily diet as it is considered a complete food in itself. Okay, so milk should also be included. Fruits and green vegetables are a rich source of vitamins and minerals. So we should eat fruits and green vegetables. And the iron-rich food like green leafy vegetables are also essential because iron is required for the formation of blood in our body. There are 5 types of nutrients: carbohydrates, fats, protein, vitamins, minerals. So our diet should include these proteins, okay, in correct proportion. Remember that we should avoid junk food like chips and packed or tinned snacks because they do not have adequate nutritional value. Thus, they are not a replacement to regular meals. Next is personal hygiene. The body of adolescents becomes smelly due to increased activity of sweat glands. So, it is important to have a bath at least once daily. There are chances of bacterial infection if cleanliness is not maintained. It means for a teenager, it becomes more essential to take care of the body. The body of adolescents becomes smelly due to increased activity of sweat glands. That's why it is important to have a bath at least once daily. And all the body parts should be washed and cleaned well. Because if we do not wash our body parts daily, then there are chances of bacterial infection. Okay? If we do not wash our body parts, then there are chances of bacterial infection. So, cleanliness should be maintained. And the girls need to take special care about personal hygiene during the time of menstrual flow. Okay, the girls need special care about personal hygiene during the time of menstrual flow. So, I repeat that the body of adolescents becomes smelly due to increased activity of sweat gland. So, it is important to have a bath at least once daily. Means all the body parts should be washed and cleaned well. Now the next way to keep our body fit is by doing physical exercise. Doing physical exercise is one of the best way to keep our body fit. Teenagers must take walk and exercise regularly. Okay, means doing physical exercise is the best way to keep our body fit. And the teenagers must do exercise regularly. They should play outdoor games instead of spending all their time on internet and other indoor activities. So this is the way by which we keep our body fit. Next way is keep away from drugs, means say no to drugs. So what are drugs? Drugs are chemical substances that produce many changes in the physical, mental, behavioral and emotional setup of an individual. If a person take them once, then he or she feel like taking them again and again. And they harm our body and ruin both health and happiness. Means, we know that it is normal for adolescents to feel confused and insecure. But remember, it is a normal part of growing up. If anybody suggests that you should take drugs to get relief, then say no. Because the drugs are harmful for our body and it produces many changes in the physical, mental, behavioral and emotional setup of a person. And the drugs are addictive. Okay, the drugs are addictive. Means if a person take them once, then he or she feel like taking them again and again. And it also harmful for our health and also ruin our happiness. So we should keep away from drugs. So what we have learned, that we should take proper amount of nutrients like carbohydrates, protein, vitamins, minerals, fats. Okay, and the second is personal hygiene, means we should wash our body parts daily, means every day, because if we don't do this, then there are chances of bacterial infection. Okay, and the other is physical exercise, means by doing physical exercise we keep our body fit. So it is very important for the teenagers to do exercise. And the next is keep away from drugs, because it harmful for our body. Say no to drugs. We should not use drugs. These are some ways to keep our body healthy. So students, there are some myths and taboos related to menstruation and the body changes that adolescents experience. And some of the myths are given below. Menstruation is a curse. A girl becomes pregnant by looking at boys during menstruation. A girl should not be allowed to work in the kitchen during menstruation. So students, these are wrong notions. It never happens. So we should discard them. We should discard these myths. Because we know that a girl can't be pregnant only by looking at boys during menstruation. Okay. So these are wrong notions and we discard them. We should discard them. So students, this is your homework. Question number 1 is, choose the correct option. A part is, adolescents should be careful about what they eat. Because, first option is, proper diet develops their brain. C Second option is, proper diet is needed for the rapid growth taking place in their body. Third option is, adolescents feel hungry all the time. Next option is, taste buds are well developed in teenagers. Students, I repeat this question, that adolescents should be careful about what they eat because proper diet develops their brain. Proper diet is needed for the rapid growth taking place in their body. Adolescents feel hungry all the time. Taste buds are well developed in teenager. So there are four options out of which only one is correct, and you have to choose the correct option. B part is, the right meal for adolescents consists of, first option is chips, noodles and coke. Second option is chapati, dal, vegetables. Third option is rice, noodles and burger. And the last option is vegetable cutlet, chips, lemon drink. Okay, out of these four, which is the right meal for adolescents? Now I'm going to discuss the homework solution of lecture 2. Question number 1 was, what is menstruation? In a female reproductive ovaries, the ova begins to mature at puberty. Okay, the ova begins to mature with the onset of puberty. And then one ovum matures and is released by one of the ovaries once in about 28 to 30 days. And during this period, the wall of uterus becomes thick so as to receive the egg. And when egg does not fertilizes, means if the fertilization does not occur, then the released egg and the thickened lining of uterus along with its blood vessels are shed off. This causes bleeding in women, which is called menstruation. Okay, this causes bleeding in women, which is called menstruation. Second question, prepare a table having two columns depicting names of endocrine glands and hormones secreted by them. So first endocrine gland is pituitary gland, and the hormones secreted by pituitary gland is growth hormone. Other is thyroid, and the hormone secreted by thyroid gland is thyroxine, means the thyroid gland produces thyroxine hormone. Next is adrenal, it secreted adrenaline hormone. Next is pancreas, the hormone secreted by pancreas is insulin. Next is testes, the hormone secreted by testes is, it is a male hormone, and the hormones secreted by testes are testosterone. And last is ovaries, and the hormone secreted by ovaries is estrogen. Okay, hormone secreted by ovaries is estrogen. So these are some names of endocrine glands and the hormones secreted by them. Question number 4. Reproductive age in women starts when their, first option is menstruation occur, second option breast starts developing, third option body weight increases, And last option, height increases. So the answer is menstruation occur. First option is correct.
Question number 3. What are sex chromosomes? Why are they named so? State their function. All human beings have 23 pair of chromosomes in the nuclei of their cells. Two chromosomes out of these are the sex chromosome named X and Y. These chromosomes determine the sex of a baby. Hence they are named sex chromosome. And the function is it determines the sex of a baby. Means in human beings there are 23 pair of chromosomes. Chromosomes are the thread-like structure which are present in the nuclei of their cells. And out of these, two chromosomes are sex chromosome, which is named as X and Y chromosome. And these chromosomes, means the X and Y chromosome, determine the sex of a baby.
Question number 5. Write note on sex determination in the unborn baby. Answer is, all human beings have 23 pair of chromosomes in the nuclei of their cells. And out of these, two chromosomes are the sex chromosomes, named as X and Y chromosome. A female has two X chromosomes, while a male has one X and one Y chromosome. The gametes, X and sperm, have only one set of chromosomes. The unfertilized egg always have one X chromosome, but sperm may have X or Y chromosome. When a sperm containing X chromosome fertilizes the egg, the zygote would have two X chromosomes and develop into a female child. Similarly, when a sperm containing Y chromosome fertilizes the egg, the zygote would have one X and one Y chromosome and develop into a male child. So this is a solution for lecture 2, and this ends for today's lecture. Thank you, students.